Hey guys, it's Vignesh from CodeAndroid. In this video, we'll see how to handle configuration changes using vModel. This is the app we have created in previous tutorials. In this, we have the search activity where we can search for a city. When we click on the search icon, it will call the search API and store the result into vModel. Now, when I rotate my screen, it will trigger the configuration change. In this case, we have the data already in our vModel, so it won't call the API again. When we click on this recycler view item, it will bring us to details activity, where we do a network call to get the current temperature. But when we rotate the screen in this activity, it's calling the API. Because in search activity, the user need to perform an action to do the API call. So vModel itself handling the configuration changes. But in this activity, the API gets called inside onCreate. So we need to decide when to call the API. If the data won't change frequently, then we can avoid calling the API. If the app has more data flow, then we can use some timer to control it. For example, call the API when configuration change happens after 10 seconds. Otherwise, don't. First, we'll see how to block the API call. In the vModel, we are storing the API response into a variable called response. So, before making the API call, we can check the response value. If it is null, then we will make the API call. This will limit the API call only once for the lifecycle of the vModel. You can see it's making the API call for the first time. When I rotate the screen, it's not calling the API anymore. Now, we'll see how to make the API call using timer. To do that, we need to store the time at which the last response received. So, I'm creating a variable called lastRequestTime, which is a type of long and initializing it with -1. Once we get the response, updating its value as system.currentTimeNulls. Now, this will have the latest time at which the response got received. So, before making the API call, we can check if system.currentTimeNulls minus lastRequestTime is greater than 10 seconds. We need to give the time in milliseconds, so I'm giving 10,000. If the condition is true, then we need to make the API call. Otherwise, we can skip it. So, I'm inverting the condition. If the difference is less than 10 seconds, then calling return, so that the below code won't get executed. In this case, we don't do this null check, so I'm removing it. Now we'll launch the application. You can see it's making the API call for the first time. When I rotate the screen within 10 seconds, it won't make the call. When it exceeds 10 seconds, then it makes the API call. Like this, we can handle the configuration changes using vModel. That's all for this tutorial, guys. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. If you have any doubts, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.